Good morning, everyone. Johnny Laser here. I've been noticing a lot of people have a problem. They're experiencing when they're cutting their wood, they're getting too many burn marks. I found a slight solution to this, and I would like to show you. Very easy. I'm going to do a snowflake, cut out a snowflake, out of two pieces of wood. They're the same type of wood. Now, let's put a mark on one of them. This one will be different. I'll put a check mark on it. That's the one that's going to be different. And how we do this is simply using, from the hardware store, two paint sticks that you use, that they give you to use to stir the paint. And what I do is I elevate the wood onto this to allow for airflow underneath. So let's give that a shot and see how the outcome comes out. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to take our first piece of wood, we're going to place it down on the honeycomb, and we're going to use our magnets here to hold it down. There we go. And for the second piece, what we're going to do is we're going to take the two parts of paint sticks, place them inside. We're going to take the piece of wood with the check mark right there, and we're going to elevate it on the paint sticks. And I'm going to use the magnet here to hold it down. All right. So we'll do this one first, and then we'll do this one next. We're going to do the autofocus. Mark our area. Now I'm only moving the machine, I move one axis at a time. So I move the Y axis and then the X. Mark it. I'll move the X and the Y. Bring it a little closer. There we go. That's one. So we'll cut one snowflake there. Alrighty, let's frame it. And let's cut it out. Okay, that one is done. We lift it up, and we're gonna move it over to this one. Now, because they are on different heights, I have to re-pick this one up. If they were both at the same level, I could have marked two different areas and cut both snowflakes at the same time. But in this case, they're different, so I have to adjust it. So let's move this over. Click off the height. Thank you. make our square for pickup, choose rectangle. Again, moving only one axis at a time. Doesn't matter which one you start with. Going with the Y first, then the X. That's one. That's two. And let's frame it. Looks good. And let's process this. And go. All right, we have our two snowflakes done. Let us see the results. Now from the first one, we can see we have some burn marks here along the top and around the antlers. On the back side, a lot of burn mark here, burning here, all along here, you got that crisscross. All right, let us see the elevated one. Now on the elevated one, very, very little. The thinner area is just a tad, but not bad, not bad at all. Let's turn it around. There's our check mark. And just a little bit on the thin area. But other than that, nothing else. Okay? And this is by elevating the piece higher. Excuse me. So what is actually happening is, if we can just show here. There we go. Let's zoom in real good here. When the laser is cutting through, and it comes where you have the honeycomb crisscrossing it and sitting on these steel pieces, the laser is heating up this steel and it's acting like the old wood burning sets. It's transferring the heat into the steel heats up, runs along the steel, and it burns back into the wood. When it is elevated, this doesn't happen. Okay, so there you go, my little trick for burning the wood, cutting it out nicely to not leave any burn marks. Very simple, very easy, and very effective. I hope this helps. I'm Johnny Laser. Send me any more topics you'd like to see, and we'll see what we can do. Until then, happy lasering. Take care. I'm going to go back to the market.